Greetings! In this video we are going to be looking at the English Folk Song, found on page 55 of the Christopher Parkening Classical Guitar Method, Volume 1. I'm going to begin by performing the piece, and then I will provide some playing recommendations. The main thing I would like to focus on in looking at this piece is controlling our bass notes. So for example, the first full measure we have this A, the next measure we're going to have an E, but we can move that thumb immediately to the A after striking that E. So I could mute at the end of this first measure, for example, A, mute E, but that's kind of a lot to think about, especially when I have eighth notes in the melody. So it's safer to simply play it, and then pick and immediately mute, and that attack will cover just the instant that A and E are playing at the same time. From that measure, I can just do a wedge with my thumb between string 6 and 5 to mute the E, and proceed to play the C. Lightly releasing our ring finger is going to mute the C, so we don't even have to do anything with our thumb as we go to G. From here, again, releasing is going to mute our note, and we can play A. We can wedge just to cover in case there's a little bit of a squeak coming off that sixth string, and so on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Measure 7, we have this A, A. I'm going to pick E and mute A, and then wedge, pick A. These kind of control techniques are just going to crispen up that sound. If we have those bass notes ringing out when they're unneeded, then it's going to make things a little muddy. So I'd encourage you to watch out for that. Another thing to consider is if we want our pinky to be more reliable, then we want to make it move more straight in and have our other fingers move into bass notes at more of a steep angle or even with a pad. If we do that, I can think about moving forward into the note with my pinky. If I don't do that, then I can end up in a situation where I'm trying to go straight in with these fingers and curl that pinky too far, and it just can't get a good secure grip. So watch out for that. But that's my main playing advice for this piece. Another thing I'll throw in at the end here is that it is a folk song. Imagine it being sung. So let yourself take a breath between the phrases. For example, at the end of measure 8, we have a repeat bar. So I get to the end of a phrase, measure 8, breathe, and into the repetition. And go ahead and listen to my recording. You'll see what I mean. Where I don't play right on the beat, I'm going to let it have a little bit of a pause. There's music that's very mechanical. Think of music that's contrapuntal. For example, the piece before this, we have two lines that have a strong sense of forward drive. However, this piece is going to be much more melodic, as though someone were singing it. So try to treat it like that as you play the melody on your guitar. Thank you very much for watching. If you find these videos helpful and you would like to help others find them as well, then I encourage you to like and subscribe. God bless and good luck.